Hello viewers, today we will be talking about linear equations, and this program is the first on this series. Okay, can I ask you one simple question? The question is, 5 added to twice a number is 91. Can you tell me the number? I'll repeat the question, 5 added to twice a number is 91. Can you tell me what number I have thought of? Yes, okay. Here is a question for you. 5 added to twice a number is 91. Let us see how do we solve it. The number, because the number is not known to me, I take the number as x, and after that, because we have to add 5 added to twice a number is 91. So, this statement has taken a mathematical form. The mathematical form of this statement is 5 plus 2x equals 91, and such type of things in mathematics we call them linear equations. Now here the number which was not known to me, I have taken that as x, and we take that as a variable. Now how do I solve for x? Because I am interested in finding the value of x. So, what do? I take the number 2x plus 5, and to remove this 5, I add negative 5 to it, and in an equation, if certain number is added onto left hand side, the same number has to be added onto the right hand side. So, negative 5 has been added onto left hand side, and the negative 5 has also been added to the right hand side of this equation. Now, since this 5x, this 5 and negative 5, they are additive inverse of each other, they are 0, their sum is 0, and 91 plus minus 5 gives me 86. So, 2x becomes equal to 86, and from here, I can get the value of x as by dividing both sides by half or multiplying by 1 by 2. So, multiplying by 1 by 2 onto the left hand side, and then multiplying by 1 by 2 onto the right hand side. And remember here that in an equation, if we multiply by the same number onto both sides of the equation does not change. And from there, I get the value of x as 43. So, here in this equation, I had taken the one variable. So, let us think of another situation where instead of one variable, we have two variables. So, what I say? I say three pencils. Let us take a situation where I am talking of three pencils and two pens, and I know the total cost of these. So, if three pencils and two pens cost us rupees 16, how possibly I can solve such a type of equation? Now, in this question, there are three pencils, the cost of pencil is not known to me, and there are two pens, and the cost of pen is also not known to me. So, what I should do for that? To do that, what I need is, I'll suppose the cost of the pencil and that of pen too. So, let's see how we frame a linear equation with that. So, I'll suppose the cost of a pencil be the cost of a pencil be equal to x, and since we had three pencils, the cost of three pencils will be equal to 3x. And also, I assume the cost of a pen to be y. And how many pens did I have? I had two pens, so the cost of two pens will be 2y. Now, the cost of three pencils and two pens together is rupees 16. The cost of three pencils and two pens together is 16. So, we get another equation, that is 3x plus 2y equals 16. And here we have two variables. The one variable is x and the another variable is y. And there is a sign of equality in between, showing that the cost of three pencils and two pens is 16. And we call these as linear equation in two variables. Now you can understand why do we call it a linear equation two variables, because there are two unknown quantities in this. The one is x and another is y. So this is one equation how we form the linear equation. Now we have to form another linear equation, another example, and see how do we get a linear equation corresponding to that. I take a question, and the question says twice a number subtracted from thrice another number is 5. Now can you frame an equation to that? We'll go in the same way, because we are talking here of two numbers, the twice a number which is subtracted from thrice another number. If we take the first number as x and another number as y, so 3x minus 2y, because this number twice a number is subtracted from thrice another number, 3x minus 2y makes it equal to 5. And in this 2, there are how many variables? The variables are once again x and y. So the equation comes 3x minus 2y equals 5, and this is also a linear equation in two variables. So whenever we have a linear equation in two variables, then the question arises as to how to solve them. The question is how to solve such type of linear equations. Now there can be so many ways, because there are two variables, so both the variables will be getting some or the other value. Let us say how do we go for the solution of these equations. Now I had an equation 3x minus 2y equals 5. By giving any arbitrary value to either x or to y, I can get the corresponding value of the other one. Supposing I give some value to x, I'll get the value of y, and if I give a value to y, I can get the value of x. So to get that, what do? We change the subject. Here I am transforming this equation by changing the subject to x will be equal to transferring this 2y to other side, or in other words, we can also say that adding 2y to both sides, I get 5 plus 2y. Since 3x was equal to this thing, so x will be equal to 5 plus 2y upon 3. Now I give any arbitrary value to y, corresponding to arbitrary value to y, I'll get one value of x. How do we calculate that? We put the value of y as 2 in this part, so I get 5 plus 2 times 2 whole divided by 3. That will give me the value of x. So on solving this, I get 5 plus 2 cross 2 is 4, because here you have to remember the Bode-Moss rule. Whenever there is addition and multiplication simultaneously occurring, we have to perform multiplication first. So 2 cross 2 is 4, added to 5 gives you 9, so that is 9 upon 3. So the value of x comes as 3. Now here the value of x is 3, and the value of y, and both these values are written in the form of an ordered pair. That ordered pair is 3, 2. Now remember one thing in an ordered pair. In an ordered pair, when we are writing the ordered pair, we are very much specific about the order of the numbers. The first number always represents the value of x. So is here, the number 3 is the value of x, and the second number is that of the y. That is a ordered pair. So whenever you are writing an ordered pair, be sure that when you are writing the ordered pair, the first value should come that of x, and the next should be that of y. So here we got the one ordered pair, that was 3 and 2. Can we possibly get more values for that? Yes, certainly we can. And the same procedure we will do. Let us say this ordered, because we can have so many ordered pairs, we can assign first value of x, another value of y. So in this case, if I am taking 2 and 1, does this satisfy this equation? To see that whether it satisfies this equation or not, what I have to do? I have to simply put the value of x and that of y in this equation. So substituting for x as 2, so that becomes 3 times 2 and minus 2 times 1, that equals 5. Now again, just now told you the rule of Bodmas. Again, there is multiplication and subtraction together. We have to carry out the multiplication first and then subtract the numbers. So 3 times 2 makes it 6 and 2 times 1 makes it 2. So 6 minus 5. So that means 6 minus 2 is 4. That comes equal to 5. And do you think that 4 is equal to 5? No, it's not. So this is a false statement. So when a particular ordered pair is not converting the given statement, the mathematical statement, into a true statement, that is not the solution, or that will not satisfy the given equation. And that ordered pair, we don't call that as a solution of the equation. Only that ordered pair will be taken as the solution of the equation which satisfies the given equation, or which turns the given equation into a. Let's see another situation. Now here is the same statement, same mathematical statement, 3x minus 2y equals 5. Now this, because there are two variables in that, that is one is x, another is y, what do we call it? This is still a linear equation, but a linear equation in two variables, one variable being x, another being y. And can you recall what was the question? The question was twice a number subtracted from 3 times another number is 5. So whenever any statement is given to you, to give it a mathematical shape, we write in the mathematical form. And while we are writing it in the mathematical form, we have to be very, very clear about supposing the variables. And variables can take any value. So if one equation is there, how many ordered pairs possibly can we find out? If one equation is there, we can always have infinite ordered pairs. Let's see some of the ordered pairs. When x is 3, y is equal to 2, because both these values, that is value of x and that of y, is satisfying the given equation. So here the corresponding ordered pair to x3 and y2 is 3, 2. Let's see another one. When I take x1 and y, the value of y minus 1, so here 3 times 1 minus 2 times minus 1, that will make it 3 plus 2, 5. So this ordered pair, 1 minus 1, again converts this statement, mathematical statement, into a true statement. Hence, this is also the solution of this equation. Let's see another ordered pair. When x is minus 1, we'll get y is equal to minus 4. And let us see whether it satisfies the given equation or not. So 3 times minus 1 minus 2 times minus 4. 3 times minus 1 will make it minus 3, minus 2 times minus 4 makes it minus 8, and because of this negative sign, that becomes plus 8. So 8 minus 3 again is 5. So that means this is the ordered pair which is also satisfying this equation. So all these ordered pairs we found, they are converting this linear equation into a true statement. So when any ordered pair converts the given statement into a true statement, we call that ordered pair as the solution of the given linear equation in two variables. But naturally now the question arises, if I have one equation, how many such ordered pairs can I have? Naturally, there will be infinite ordered pairs which can be the solutions of the given equation. So how do we find those infinite ordered pairs? Let's see that. Those ordered pairs which convert the given equation into a true statement, those are called the solutions of the linear equation in two variables. And because any equation, any single linear equation can have infinite number of ordered pairs, so that means this equation will have infinite ordered pairs as its solutions. So we have seen that a linear equation in two variables, for that equation we can have so many ordered pairs which are the solutions of the given equation. Let us see that if some of these solutions are plotted on the graph paper, how do they look like? For this, we need a graph paper, and the graph paper is here. In this graph paper, we draw one horizontal line over here and another vertical line like that. The point where these two lines are intersecting, this is called the origin. And this point has the ordered pair as 0, 0. Any distances measured onto the right of the origin on this side, they are taken positive, and the distances measured upwards of the origin, they are also taken as positive. But what about the distances which are measured onto the left and downwards? The distances measured onto left and downwards are taken as negative. So let's plot some of the ordered pairs which we found in the previous equation. The first ordered pair we found was 3, 2. And to plot that point 3, 2, recall that in an ordered pair, the first number always corresponds to value of x and the second number corresponds to the value of y. So to take the ordered pair 3, 2, what way we will go? We will first measure three distances, and for this, on graph paper, you can choose any convenient scale whatsoever you can. But here I am taking one square as one unit. So, 3 units, this is 0, 1, then 2, and 3. And then y was how much? 2 units. For that, since 2 is a positive number, so we will go up, this is 1, and this is 2. So, this point is the ordered pair 3, 2. And another ordered pair I took was 1, minus 1. Now, 1 again corresponds to x. So, one distance I move there. And for minus 1, which way I will move? Up or down? Minus 1 is negative number. So, I will be moving down. So, 1 minus 1 is here. And another ordered pair I had taken was minus 1 and minus 4. So, where to put minus 1, minus 4? Once again, the same rule will follow. The minus 1 has to be measured onto the left hand side of the origin. So, here is minus 1. And for minus 4, again I go down 1, 2, 3, and 4. So, this first order pair is 3, 2. The second order pair is 1, minus 1. And the third order pair is minus 1, minus 4. Now, what do these three ordered pairs have in common? If I join them by a scale, they are all lying on the same straight line. So, this being a straight line, that is why we call equation 3x minus 2y equals 5 a linear equation. And any point on this line will be satisfying the given linear equation, or in other words, this will be solution of the linear equation. So, if I take one point over here, say this is the point, and if I have to get the ordered pair for this, what do? I plot the perpendicular first onto x axis and then onto y axis. So, let us measure these distances. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5 distances horizontally, that is positive 5. And how much is the upper distance? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is also 5. So, that is ordered pair corresponding to this is 5, 5. Now, let us see, does it satisfy the given equation? The equation was 3x minus 2y equals 5. So putting the values of x and y, I get 3 times 5 will be 15 minus 2 times 5 is 10. So 15 minus 10 is 5. So this does get converted into a true statement. Hence, this is also the solution. So that means if whenever I have one linear equation in two variables, it will have infinite solutions. And all those solutions will be lying on which particular line? On the line for which we have plotted the graph, this line. See it once again. And any point, if I take outside this line, let us take, if I take this point, now the ordered pair corresponding to this is the 4, because 4 is the distance on the horizontal side towards right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 and 2, that has been measured downwards. So this becomes 4 minus 2. So will this 4 minus 2 satisfy this equation? Let's check that. This is once again the equation is 3x minus 2y equals 5. So if I put the value of x as 4, that becomes 12, and value of y taking as minus 2, that becomes plus 4 equals 5, and 12 plus 4 is 16. So obviously 16 is not equal to 5. So hence this is not the solution of the equation 3x minus 2y equals 5. So in a linear equation in two variables, what do you find? When we plot its graph, it is always a straight line, and any point on the straight line is the solution of that equation, and any point outside that line is not a solution of that equation, because the point outside the line does not convert the given statement into a true statement. But in case instead of one, we have two equations, then what will happen? Now, prior to that, instead of taking two equations, let us tell you very frankly that the knowledge of algebra was passed on from Arabians to Europeans. The knowledge of algebra was passed from Arabians to Europeans, but prior to that, it was very well known to the Indian mathematicians, the Aryabhatta. Indian mathematicians had also worked on this concept, and they called this as Bijagnit. The person who did a lot of work on this part of linear equation was Aryabhatta, and the another person, Brahmagupta, in 598 AD, he is known to be the master of solving the linear equations in two variables. But now, let us see in case of if we have one equation that has infinite solutions, and when we have two equations, then what will happen? In case we have two equations like this, the first is 3x plus 2y equals 16, another is 5x minus 3y equals 14. These two equations will form a system of linear equations. And to solve the system of linear equations, we can have either hit and trial method. The hit and trial method means that I'll get so many ordered pairs for the first equation and so many ordered pairs for the second equation. But that is quite cumbersome, so we go for either algebraical method, and the various algebraical method which we employ for solving the system of linear equations are elimination by substitution. The second method is elimination by equating coefficients or by method of cross multiplication. Now, let us solve the system of linear equations by elimination by substitution. Here, what we will be doing is that we will take the equations, and in both the equations, I will be changing the subject to x. Look at the first equation. The first equation is 3x plus 2y equals 16, and from here I get x equals 16 minus 2y upon 3, and from second equation, 5x minus 3y equals 14, which gives me the value of x as 14 plus 3y upon 5. Now, from both these equations, I have found the value of x, and these values will be equated. So, while equating, let us see how we write down this step. We will equate these two values, To equate these two values, that means we'll have 16 minus 2y upon 3 equals 14 plus 3y upon 5. And then in the next step, what do we go for? We go for the cross multiplication, that is 5 is multiplied onto this side and 3 will go that side. So that becomes 5 times 16 minus 2y equals 3 times 14 plus 3y. Now using distributive law, 5 times 16 is 80 minus 5 times 2 is 10y equals 3 times 14, 42, and 3 times 3y equals 9y. Now while opening these brackets, be careful that you use the proper distributive law. And that makes it first 80 minus 10y. I add 10y to both sides of the equation because the equation does not change if we put the same value, add or subtract the same value onto both sides of the equation. That makes it 80 equals 42 plus 19y. And now subtracting 42 from both sides, I get 80 minus 42 equals 42 minus 42 plus 19y. That is 38 equals 19y. And from here, dividing both sides by 19, we get y equals 2. So let's have a look at those equations once again. The first equation was 3x plus 2y is equal to 16. And the second is 5x minus 3y equals 14. We had transformed them into x. X equals 16 minus 2y on 3. And x equals 14 plus 3y on 5. And we have found out the value of y as 2. This value of y is substituted in any one of these equations to get the corresponding value of x. So when we put the value of x, we get x equals 16 minus 2 into 2 whole divided by 3. Now here I am putting the value of y 2 in the first equation. And after solving that, we get x equals 16 minus 4 on 3. And that makes it the value of x as 4. So we got ordered pair by elimination method. That is, the ordered pair is 4, 2. And 4, 2 is a solution of the given system. That is, this ordered pair will be satisfying the first equation as well as the second equation. Now, let's have the graph of these two equations and see how the graph looks like. For plotting the graph, once again, we have to get the ordered pairs, and here are the ordered pairs for the first equation, and this was the first equation, and the ordered pairs we get are 8 minus 4, 4, 2, and 6 minus 1. And for the second one, we have 5x minus 3y equals 14. The ordered pairs are 4, 2, 1, minus 3, minus 2. So viewers, we talked about linear equation in two variables and system of linear equations in two variables and learnt one of the methods of solving the linear equations. We shall talk about it in the next lesson. Till then, goodbye.